We have a special edition today. We're early on a Thursday here with Howard Felixrod, right? Owner of Blue Moon Restaurant here in Wyckoff, New Jersey. And this is an awesome treat. Welcome to Coffee with Marcy.
Thank you. Thank you for having me.
Oh my God, it's so awesome. Beth has just joined us. She's a regular at your restaurant.
That's right.
My sister-in-law, which we all love. Blue Moon Restaurant.
Thank you.
Yes.
Appreciate
so, now that we've had someone join, so let's talk about you. Tell us about yourself.
Well, I've been in the restaurant business for about, well, my whole life, but Blue Moon has been around for 30 years.
30 years?
Yeah, we started in Manhattan
in
1987. Mm-hmm. We opened in Chelsea, and at one point we had three in Manhattan. And then when I opened up in Englewood in 1995, we were paying half the rent and doing 30% more business, and I'm like, there's no reason to be in Manhattan. So we started out here.
Yes. Wonderful. Well, we're glad that you ended up in Wyckoff too.
Yeah. Well, we moved here as a family. Well, me and my wife moved here in '93
mm-hmm.
or '94.
Okay.
And then when I was a kid, my father had restaurants, and I always wanted him to have one in our hometown.
Yeah.
But he didn't.
No.
So, but I always wanted one in my hometown, and we opened here in 2000.
Oh, it's been 2000.
Yeah.
All right, because we moved here not too long after that.
Yeah.
Yeah, so we have a couple of people saying hello.
Hello.
Wilson, Englewood, Blue Moon, the best.
Nice.
So why did you pursue your career in the restaurant business?
Well, as I said, I grew up in the business. My father, he had a luncheonette in Queens when I was a kid. And I loved going to work there, making egg creams and ice cream sodas and probably eating half of them.
Mm-hmm.
And then at some point he went into the Mexican restaurant business in Manhattan in the early 80s. And
mm-hmm.
my brother and I worked there. And we just, you know, I love the business. I love talking to people, meeting people. And eventually we opened up our own place,
mm-hmm.
like I said. And I just enjoy it.
So he had a Mexican food restaurant, which is why you decided to open one?
Yes.
Yes.
And it's funny because when he first told me that he was going into business with this other gentleman and they were opening a Mexican restaurant,
uh-huh.
I said, Dad, who eats Mexican food? Nobody eats Mexican food. And sure enough, everybody did.
Well, there is a need for Mexican food restaurants here because, well, I'm from Houston, so they're everywhere.
Yeah.
But I noticed that there's a lot of Italian restaurants, right?
Yep. So Italian, Chinese.
Exactly.
You know, yeah. So there is, you know, well, now there's really a Mexican restaurant in every town. And
right.
When we first came to Englewood, that we were one of very, very few Mexican restaurants in the area.
Right.
So.
How many restaurants do you have?
We have four locations now.
Okay.
We have Englewood, Wyckoff, Woodcliff Lake,
mm-hmm.
and one in Bronxville in Westchester.
Okay.
And we're about to embark on an out-of-state experience. We're opening in Boca Raton, Florida.
That's awesome.
Yeah, we should be opening another 4 weeks or so.
Wow.
So we're very excited about that.
And Boca's so wonderful.
Yeah, it's great. We're going to have a huge outdoor patio
mm-hmm.
on a man-made lake.
Oh, beautiful.
Yeah, so everybody can sit outside overlooking the water. And nice breeze coming in, and it's
right.
very nice.
And I know a lot of us visit Florida and Boca Raton, so at least we know we can get Blue Moon while we're there.
Yeah, I think half the people down there are from either New York or New Jersey, so hopefully we'll have a built-in crowd. So
how long does it take since inception? Like, you decide you're going to move to a certain town, like, to open a restaurant?
Always a lot longer than even I think.
Yeah.
But I would say from purchasing or leasing a place to opening, minimum of 6 months.
6 months.
Yeah. So you know, between the permits, the liquor license transfer, the build out, and you know everything takes a little while. But 6 months is probably the minimum.
That's the minimum.
Yeah.
So tell me about your menu, putting together your menu, and any specialty items. I love your menu. My new favorite, I just have to say, are the cauliflower tacos.
Aren't they great?
Yes.
Yeah, we needed a vegetarian item, and cauliflower is a new popular item, so we just figured out a way to incorporated that into a taco. And
yeah.
Yeah, it's actually one of my favorite dishes also.
Yeah.
And, you know, we our old recipes are there. We are mm-hmm. our main staple items are rice, beans, and our chili. Those come actually from a recipe from our original chef was a woman about 75 years old.
Uh-huh.
And she was working in our kitchens and worked harder than anybody I know. And we learned the recipes from her. And then we took them and brought them along the way. But we created, I like to cook. I'm not a trained chef, but I really enjoy cooking.
Mm-hmm.
So I've created a lot of our recipes along the way.
Oh, cool.
And the my favorites are, well, I love our steak. The skirt steak, the steak fajitas. It's just a great cut of meat and very flavorful and juicy. And we have an Aztec steak, which is a big skirt steak with uh-huh. cheese, and we put cactus on it.
Oh.
They're called the Nepalis.
Okay.
And it's delicious. Yeah.
I just have to say, my son always eats the fajitas,
yeah.
The steak fajitas.
Yeah.
That's
and
what he chooses now.
Yeah. We actually even have good hamburgers, because that's my favorite food in the world.
A burger?
It's a good hamburger. And so.
Well, I love that you have the kids menu that you have, too.
Yeah.
Because, you know, children don't like Mexican food.
Yeah, a lot of kids won't eat it. And,
exactly.
You know, we try to get everybody, we don't want to turn anybody away, and we like the kids to get started. Here and I learned this as my kids grew up in the business,
mm-hmm.
what they wanted, and
yeah,
and you know, we have pasta, chicken strips, small tacos, anything for the kids.
My daughter loves the chicken strips.
Yeah, good.
You know, and it's good that you offer breaded or not, because well, my daughter gets the breaded, but
yeah, you know, people are trying to be healthier now.
Yes,
and so we try to offer those.
That's nice.
Those items, yeah.
And so you also, you have the new cauliflower. You have some other vegetarian items?
Yeah, everything on our menu, if it does not say meat,
okay.
is vegetarian.
Oh, okay.
There's a lot of Mexican restaurants use lard
mm-hmm.
in their beans.
Mm-hmm.
We do not. We
okay.
use honey oils. Our rice is also vegetarian.
Okay.
So if it doesn't say meat, you know it's vegetarian.
Oh, that's good to know.
Yeah, a lot of, again, there's more and more people becoming vegetarian,
yes.
so we like to please everybody.
That's wonderful. Yeah. So I just have to say, Wilson is saying they need a rooftop in Inglewood.
You know, we've actually discussed it, but that's a long way off.
Yeah. So, well, let's talk about your new bar, which is awesome, and your specialty drinks. I know everyone enjoys that.
Yeah, the bar here, not so new anymore. We were here for 11 years without a bar, and then we put it in 2012, and it was one of the greatest things we've done.
Yeah.
You know, it's really become a neighborhood hangout, and
yes.
you know, people love coming in here. We have live music on the weekends.
Mm-hmm.
We have good local bands and some bands that we bring in, but it's a fun crowd.
Mm-hmm.
And you know, people love our margaritas.
Yes.
You know, thank goodness.
So you have some specialty margaritas?
Yeah, we do a Cadillac margarita, which is most places do, but
mm-hmm.
it's top upper end tequila. And a better version of triple sec.
Okay.
And you know, floated with Grand Marnier on top, which
mm-hmm.
is people love.
Mm-hmm.
We do a drink called the Wolf, which is a margarita with jalapenos in it.
Oh my!
And it's a spicy, nice spicy drink.
Yeah.
We actually also bought last year. We bought a barrel of tequila that they made specially for us.
Really?
Patron made it for us. It's called a barrel aged tequila.
Mm-hmm.
It was made in a I think it was a whiskey cask that
okay.
they aged it in.
Yeah.
So we have what we call a Bam Bam.
Mm-hmm.
It's a barrel-aged tequila margarita with mango. Mango margarita. So it's a great.
So it has a different flavor in the barrel? Is that
yeah.
what it is?
It's an an oaky flavor.
Yeah.
Call it, you know, smoky flavor.
Right.
So it's a nice tequila. Very nice.
Cool.
Yeah. So it's fun.
Well, I know that there's a lot of fun times that have been had here at the bar.
Yes.
And speaking of fun, tomorrow's Cinco de Mayo, so what do you have special for that?
Well, it's our biggest day of the year.
Yes.
It's amazing to me that every year, no matter what day of the week it is, on Cinco de Mayo, people pile in and,
mm-hmm.
and it's become a national holiday.
Yes.
We bring in mariachis,
mm-hmm.
they come around, they come inside and outside and they sing and people love it, you know.
Yeah.
We have specials with Dos Equis, five for $25 a bucket.
Okay.
We have extra bars set up so people can get to their drinks. So
that's
they don't
nice.
Have to wait at the bar.
Yes.
And
You've thought of everything then.
It's really a fun day, and unfortunately the weather's not looking great tomorrow, but we're still having a big party.
Right.
So,
Everyone will just crowd in, right?
Yep. All locations. So.
All locations. Yeah. Oh, fun. I got to check out some of your other locations.
Yeah, you should. It's they're all a little bit different, but they have a similar theme running through them.
Yes, I've been to the Englewood one.
Yeah.
And then Wyckoff, but to check out Bronxville. And I definitely want to check out Boca Raton.
Yeah, we'll have to have you down for the grand opening.
That would be awesome. Yeah. And I have a good friend that lives in Boca Raton, so I'll make sure that she goes.
Oh, great. That'd be great.
And when we visit. So, what is your philosophy? Tell us about that.
Well, I think the biggest thing is, there are restaurants that have great food, restaurants that have great service. But what I want people to do is, I want them to leave here and say, I had a great time.
Mm-hmm.
I think that's our main focus. But I think that focus, though, comes from service.
Mm-hmm.
And I really am a stickler for good service.
Yeah.
And so we try to hire people with great attitudes.
Mm-hmm.
And I think that's the key to our success. I've been to restaurants where the food was amazing, mm-hmm. but the service was terrible.
Yes.
I'll never go back.
I know.
And vice versa, where the food was mediocre, but the service was great, I'll definitely go back.
Yeah.
So it's really a big focus for us.
Well, I tell you, I always have had great service.
Yeah, great.
Everyone has a smile, and they help each other.
Yeah.
It's not like, sometimes you go to restaurants and they get a section, and then it's like, I don't work over there,
Exactly, yeah. What we call a pool house, they all pool their tips, and that makes them work together.
Mm.
And they work as a team. And again, it's all about attitude.
Yeah. So. They all have a good attitude.
Yeah. And we have a good manager, that keeps them in.
Oh, yeah, you have a great manager.
Yeah. And that's also the key, too.
Absolutely. So, yeah. Well, we miss you when you're not here, though.
Thank you.
You can't be everywhere.
That's true. That's true.
Wilson said Andy is the best.
Yeah. Andy's great. Yeah. That's good.
So I know you do a lot for the community.
Yes.
Let's talk about that.
Yeah, we do give back a lot. I don't know the number offhand, but over the last 15 years, we've probably donated back $400,000 to the community.
I see your name everywhere. You do absolutely a lot for the community. It's amazing.
Yeah, we like to give back. We feel we're here, we're part of the community, and mm-hmm. we should be giving back. We do a lot of what we call community nights where any organization can come in, and they set it up with my office, and they can come in, and that night we'll donate 20% of the checks of the people that come in for that organization.
Mm-hmm.
And we've had ones where we've donated $80, and we've had where we've donated $500, and it all depends on the group.
Mm-hmm.
As a matter of fact, next Tuesday, we're running a golf outing,
mm-hmm.
and we're raising money. This year, this is our fourth annual golf outing. We're raising money for the Wyckoff Volunteer Fire Department.
Oh, wonderful.
And we hope to raise about $20,000 to $25,000 for them.
Yeah.
And they're a great organization. These guys work selflessly.
Selflessly,
and,
yeah.
And they put an hour after hour of training. We really appreciate it.
Wow.
So we're trying to raise money for them. Last year we did it for a gentleman in town who was suffering from cancer, and the year before that we did it to raise money for the fields in town, the brand new fields.
Thank you for that.
Yeah, it's a fun time, and we also hire some people, special needs people to work.
Right.
Today they're here cleaning, and they're really just putting in some hours to work, and so they could feel. Thanks. Oh, there we go.
We're back.
And you asked me if we worked with the Reed Academy.
The Reed Academy, yes.
We have done work with them, actually. Some friends of ours are on the board over there.
Uh-huh.
I hate to say, I'm not sure what the group that's working here now is from. I think Quest.
Okay.
Yeah. And we've worked with a lot of different organizations. Yeah.
That means a lot, because I know they're always looking for businesses that will help. So that's huge that you're giving them the opportunity to have a responsibility like this.
Yeah, it's a nice, we feel it's a nice thing to do. And, gives them a purpose, which is good.
Absolutely. Yeah. So thank you. And also, there's some more things. There's some fairs coming up. Are you involved in those?
We do some of them. We do a lot of these tasting events.
You're right.
We're table to table. There's another charitable organization where we'll go and donate food. you know, among many, many other restaurants.
Right.
We'll do, like, there's a Pearl River chili cook-off we do. Wyckoff Day coming up.
Right, that's the Wyckoff Day.
Yeah, yep. On June 3rd at the YMCA.
Okay, yeah, that's a big day.
Yeah, it's a mm-hmm. huge day. And we're there. We'll be selling our tacos. I'm also the president of the Chamber of Commerce, so we're raising money again for the fire department with the Ducky Derby.
Oh, the Ducky Derby. Yeah, yes, so, everyone knows about the Ducky Derby. Yeah.
So we're selling ducks here at Blue Moon and many other businesses in town. You can buy ducks. And,
right.
And you can win prizes.
Oh, that's great.
Yeah.
So what about, there was one other question I wanted to ask you. So is there anything else that you want to share with the viewers to leave them with?
We appreciate all the business over the years. Mm-hmm. It's very rare for a restaurant to last that long, and we're very thankful. And just want everybody to come out for Cinco and come in. We have TVs for all the sporting events. Mm-hmm. And it's just, you know, it's a fun night here at Blue Moon. We always try to make it like I said, you want to make sure you leave with a good time.
Yes, yeah, so Blue Moon, again, you have four restaurants.
Correct.
So that's, tell them again, please.
We have Wyckoff, mm-hmm. Englewood, Woodcliff Lake, and Bronxville in New York.
Right, and the one opening up in Boca Raton.
In Boca, right, correct.
And they have great food. They don't cook with lard.
Right, right.
Vegetarian options. They have a great kids menu.
Yeah. Everything is also made from scratch. The only two things we don't make are French fries and breaded chicken strips, which we
okay.
love. But everything
else
is made from scratch.
Well, that's great to hear. Everything's
yeah.
made from scratch.
Yeah.
And awesome drinks. And they all have drinks. Yeah. Do they yep. all have a bar?
Every place, yeah. We all have bars. And
okay.
We all have great margaritas.
Great margaritas, great staff, so it's an awesome restaurant, and we really appreciate all you do in the community, Howie, and we love the restaurant, so cheers, cheers.
Yeah, cheers.
Here's to Cinco de Mayo and Blue Moon.
Yeah. Thanks.
Thank you guys for joining, yeah. And I will also air this again tomorrow in my normal spot, Friday 1:30 on Cinco de Mayo, so stay tuned. Yeah. Have the fun graphics on.
Thank you very much.
All right. Thanks, Howie. Bye.